couple, it's Friday, and that means we have a pet on our set looking for a forever home. Terra Acox with the Midland Humane Coalition has brought a tender, loving, special friend right here named Kevin.
Yeah.
He's very cute.
So cute. Can you tell us a little bit about Kevin?
So Kevin's about a year and a half old. We actually also have his daughter. So he's a Chiweenie. Wow. And he was found in a home that had already had too many pets. Mm. No one was spayed or neutered. So we took in a couple, he and his daughter, and now they're fixed and they're vaccinated and they're ready to get homes of their own.
Ready to be rehomed. How sweet, a Chiweenie. Mm-hmm. I've never heard of a mix like that. That's very cute. I did think he was a little bit of a weed in a dog when he was walking in though with his little legs. He's just too precious. Where do you think he'd fit best? What kind of home?
Probably not with small children because he's little himself and he's very timid. Mm-hmm. So a lot of times when dogs are timid like that, they might react aggressively, just kind of in defense if they're scared. Oh, so we probably don't want him in a home with little kids, but pretty much anyone besides that, somebody who's looking for a lap dog, he'd be perfect. He loves to sit in laps and have pets and cuddles. So.
And he's a great face for Instagram, too. You just see the little eyebrows. And no, he just is so sweet. When he walked in, automatically, he was just, you just knew that he would be that beautiful lap dog. Mm. But is there anything else that we need to know about Kevin?
He's very fearful. That could, some of that could kind of ease up with some time. A shelter environment is not the best for, you know, being calm and relaxed, obviously. So anybody who takes him home, just be prepared to be really patient with him until he gets comfortable and then he really starts to open up.
And you mentioned that he's about a year old?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So he's a young guy, but already has a kid living his life. No, but he does have very beautiful markings, and he is a little bit timid. I was holding him earlier, and he was shaking a tiny bit. So, yeah, that patience is probably very important, but he seems like such a sweet dog.
Yeah, he's ready to be loved.
Mm-hmm. And he's neutered, too.
Yes.
So that's really good because it cuts back costs for people who are maybe trying to save.
Mm-hmm. Exactly.
Booking an appointment can sometimes be really difficult out here.
Yeah, and there can
be
a waiting list, you know. So.
Yeah.
Definitely.
So no children, but what about other dogs? Is that something too that, you know, what if they want to adopt his daughter with him?
That would be a dream come true. Aww. Because obviously they're very close, they're related, so they'd love to go to the same home. He does get along with dogs. Okay. He's afraid of cats, probably because of his size. You can see he's probably no bigger than a cat.
Mm-hmm.
So maybe if you have cats, you want a laid-back cat to be around Kevin, to be in the same home. But you can always do a trial adoption. We always encourage that. So if you have any concerns about how he might react to anything in your home and you want to just bring him home for like a week or so and just see how he does, then that's a great idea.
And you also do have an event coming up as well.
Yes, we do. So in addition to our events, the Blue Door is having their anniversary event, and we're just so grateful to them because they're doing a raffle to benefit Midland Humane Coalition. So this guitar right here, Tito's guitar.
Very cool.
Yes, they're selling raffle tickets for that. And you can find out more about that on our Facebook page or our website, midlandhumane.org, or on the Blue Doors Facebook page.
Amazing. And if people want to adopt Kevin or learn more information, where can they go?
Well, you can always go to the PetSmart in Midland. We're open 7 days a week. And you can check out all the adoptable pets online at midlandhumane.org.
All right, well, thank you so much for being in our studio this morning, Tara. But now I'm going to send things back on over to our chief meteorologist, Chase Menendez, for another look at your forecast.
Now, your weather right